Fantasialand in Brühl near Cologne can be described as a theme park that is undergoing a transformation like no other. Due to the limited space, it has regularly had to completely reinvent itself for new attractions over the last two decades. This meant that older areas and attractions often disappear completely to make room for new themed areas and rides, so that Fantasialand could continue to play in the upper league of European theme parks with each new attraction and with each new theme area. At the latest, since Deep in Africa, new hikes were strived for again and again, thereby not only incredibly detailed and imaginative themed areas were created, but also some of the best and most unique rides and roller coasters that made the park famous far beyond the borders of Germany. So that you know which attractions and rides you should not miss as soon as the season can begin in the second pandemic year, here are my top 10 rides and roller coasters at Fantasialand for 2021. Rank 10. Vinjars 4 and 4. This ranking is opened by two roller coasters which turn the heads of their passengers in the indoor area Wusthauen. Vinjars 4 and 4 is a double roller coaster of the spinning coaster type built by the German manufacturer Maurerride. The two quite different layouts ensure that you should definitely try both sides of this roller coaster creation as well. But don't worry, both rides remain very family friendly overall. Both focus on exploring the beautifully designed interior of the Wusthauen building, but can provide some serious spin depending on the load. Both layouts are spiced up by little trick track moments, which you are welcome to be surprised by. In my eyes, a family coaster with great integration into a weather independent indoor area, and thus a well-deserved 10th place in my ranking. But be careful to not get lost in the waiting area, which is a bit confusing. Rank number 9. Raik. For rank 9, we almost go to the other end of the park. In the medieval fantasy village of Klugheim, the Vekoma family boomerang Raik has been making its rounds since summer 2016 as a sidekick to the thrill coaster Terran and takes willing passengers on a short journey through time. Even though Raik was created as a family-friendly ride through the canyons of Klugheim, I may say that this one is one of the faster and more intense family boomerang coasters from the Dutch manufacturer. Being embedded deep down in the village's grounds does its part to add to the sense of speed of this forward and backward adventure ride. But that shouldn't stop families from taking the little trip back in time on this coaster. Because the ride is not really aggressive and should therefore be a very good option for those who are still a bit afraid of the big Terran. Thus, Raik enters the station steaming as a nicely integrated and designed sidekick coaster at rank 9 of my top 10 rides at Fantasialand. Rank 8. Maus au Chocolat. After two roller coaster creations, we make a thematic change on rank 8. Because the large square of the old Berlin themed area holds the entrance to an indoor family fun you should not miss. With Maus au Chocolat, Fantasialand has hidden behind the facades of Berlin an interactive 3D dark ride that is well worth seeing. The fun ride through the large bakery and confectionery takes you through a variety of differently designed rooms. From the cold store to the storage rooms to the sales counter, the passenger must rid the company of mice infestation. For this purpose, sugar ball cannons are available with which the mouse infestation can be shot at in 3D on screens. But even if the little rodents seem almost too cute to shoot down, don't hesitate because you have to collect points, otherwise your competitors will quickly beat you to the punch. The interactive dark ride with the literally sweet theme makes it with good ideas, great design and good sound staging sugar balling to my rank 8. Therefore, sugar fire ahead! Rank number 7. Mystery Castle. With rank 7, we go to the first time in this ranking in the direction of the clearly thrill-oriented attractions. In the Mystery Castle Tower, an indoor freefall awaits you. By the way, it is the only one of its kind in Germany, and there are not many freefall experiences in Europe that are completely installed in buildings. In the cellars of this mysterious tower, the slightly disturbing professor of the castle is waiting for the daring passengers. Together, you'll have to use your energy to fight the evil under the roof of the tower. To do this, you'll have to let the Intamin ballistic drop tower installed on the inner walls of the tower shoot you up to the roof. At a height of 65 meters, your strength will now be pitted against the evil. The Mystery Castle offers three different ride programs depending on the crowds. Repeat rides are recommended here. With its independence from the weather, a slightly crazy professor and a pretty decent thrill potential, Mystery Castle enters my rank 7 of Fantasialand's attractions. Rank 6. Talokan. We now go to the Mexican themed area and visit a god. With Talokan, a quite rare giant suspended topspin from Huss Rides has settled here. Normally I don't like topspins that much, but this large version convinced me. The seating comfort cannot be compared to the funfair version of the topspin, and the theming and show elements Fantasialand has combined this ride with makes Talokan a must ride for me when visiting the park. The ride is also much smoother than the smaller versions, and the soundtrack and fire and water effects really enhance the ride. The Mexican deity goes down with thrill factor, comfort and great showmanship and settles firmly into 6th place in my top attractions at Fantasialand. Rank number 5. Chiapas. Number 5 is also located in Mexico and comes in the form of a prototype Lokflume ride from Intamin. The highly modern Lokflume takes passengers on a journey through excavation sites and celebrations of Mexican traditions. From archaeology camps to party temples, it's all here. The ride uses multiple switches and a total of 5 levels including reverse descents. Chiapas also holds the record for the steepest descent on a Lokflume, as the final big drop is 53 degrees steep. This is followed by a hill which also allows the water ride to even offer some airtime. Also a novelty for this type of ride. The snappy soundtrack should not remain unmentioned here, which has for me times quite bad earworm character. The varied theming, long ride and many unique elements wash this Lokflume ride without further ado on my rank 5. Rank 4. Colorado Adventure. Formerly part of the Western Town and today assigned to Mexico, Colorado Adventure is a mine train at Fantasialand that is considered to be one of the best Vekoma mine trains ever. Even if the roller coaster looks very compact from the outside, this should not mask the very long ride. The mine train offers a total of 3 lift hills, which offers enough potential for an exciting ride through tunnels and canyons. The coaster, which is still suitable for families, does not shy away from crossing paths with the Chiapas water ride. The layout relies more on tight turns, drops and helices, as well as several tunnel crossings. Even though the tunnel areas unfortunately still lack any real landscaping, and the ride is quite rough in places, I consider Colorado Adventure to be one of the best roller coasters of its type. Only very few of these mine train coasters are really running smooth, and the fast train at Fantasialand easily makes up for this with variety and length. Thus, the Colorado Adventure winds its way to the 4th place without a lack of coal and holds it round after round. Rank number 3. Black Mamba. For rank 3 we go to Africa. With this themed area, which opened in 2006, Fantasialand brought the first and so far only inverted coaster by Bolliger & Mabillard Yard to Germany. For this coaster today, they not only choose an extremely compact layout, but also sank a large part of the track into the canyons of the African jungle. The Black Snake shows itself mostly only through windows and between rock gorges to disappear immediately again in tunnels. The coaster is one of the most compact of its kind and still manages to bring 4 inversions and many strong moments into the layout. The ride mainly relies on recurring positive G-forces with light weightless moments in the twists and turns between the many curves and helices surrounded by rocks. You stay dangerously close to the ground with your legs for long parts of the layout. But don't worry, even with longer legs, the ride on the giant snake is of course absolutely safe. With the incredibly tight integration into Deep in Africa, the intense G-forces and many foot chopper moments, the somewhat short but intense ride experience of the Black Mamba settles firmly at number 3 in my top 10 list of the best rides at Fantasialand. Rank number 2. Fly. If you've always wanted to fulfill your dream of flying, your path should lead you to Rockburg. Fantasialand's newest themed area was recently soft opened in late summer 2020 and contains a roller coaster that can't be experienced anywhere else at the moment, because once again Fantasialand dared to create a prototype. This is a completely new interpretation of the flying coaster from Vekoma. With state-of-the-art technology and precise manufacturing, they have created a flying experience through a steampunk world that is well worth seeing. It is an almost literal flight. The smoothness with which the very long trains wind through the curves can hardly be described. There isn't any slight bump or unsteadiness in the rolling behavior. I was very impressed by this. But this fits even better to the overall concept this flying coaster follows, because we are not talking about a new ultimate thrill ride. We are talking about a roller coaster that takes the concept of flying incredibly seriously and can deliver just as convincingly. There are no excessively strong G-forces and also completely no sections that are ridden through lying on your back. Even though the reclined position might not appeal to some guests, Fly makes its rounds firmly in my second place and should not be missed, because this flying coaster takes the concept of flying incredibly well and convinces with an unbelievable overall package of the latest technology, LSM accelerations and high precision manufacturing. This coaster could have taken first place if I wasn't also a thrill seeker and if there wasn't... Rank number 1, Terron. Back to Klugheim, because we are not yet finished with the medieval village. The main attraction of the themed area is without a doubt Terron. The Intamin Blitz coaster with two launches is not only the highlight of the mystery themed area, but for me also clearly the highlight of Fantasialand. With this action-packed roller coaster ride, they broke several records in 2016. Among other things, the ride relies on the most powerful LSM launch ever installed to shoot the trains onto the ride's long as well as tightly wounded layout that offers the most track crossings of any roller coaster of this type ever. This was also necessary, because Terron winds extremely compact but also very long through the canyons and buildings of Klugheim. Shooting out of the depths of below the village, it's off on a roller coaster ride that's a wash and doesn't leave you miss the missing inversions at the end at all. The many tight turns, short airtime moments and accelerations offer a variety rarely experienced. Terron keeps drawing me to repeat rides in the medieval fantasy village and has never disappointed. Come rain or shine, this creation has always been able to place itself as the highlight of my day, so I can't help but put the multi-launch coaster in my undisputed number one spot of Fantasialand's attractions and rides. This ranking is of course based on my personal experience, opinion and taste. Does your ranking look different? Then let me know in a comment. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and don't hesitate to subscribe if you want to see more. To stay up to date, you can also follow my other social media channels.